Everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to Teen Intrigue here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for the support here as the like streak is back on track. And as you do see down there below in the middle part of your screen, there is a new like streak goal. It's going to be a cashless week, which basically means I'm not allowed to spend money at all, ever, in those runs for Isaac. So that means no stores, no beggars or anything like that, no judgments. I think I should be allowed to donate stuff, though. I'm allowed to pick up money. I'm just not allowed to spend it on items or anything, no matter what. So I think that's a pretty neat idea. Someone on the subreddit brought it up, and I kind of like it. It's a different approach to the Like Streak Challenge. And yeah, so that's what we're going to do at the 120-day in a row goal. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by Baba Sarah Kate W. YouTube demonetizes Invicta. What did I get demonetized for? YouTube. I mean, technically speaking, actually, YouTube, you're the only one who knows, because I definitely don't know. Got the D1 Hizzle. Today's going to be Lima Delta, November, Quebec, 1 Juliet Sierra Alpha. We've got Little Chub. Little Chub, fantastic damage. Good tiers rate, good movement speed. Yeah, this is a good start. I could use the D100, but, actually, I would be sad if we lost these stats, you know? I think there's a time and a place for rerolls, for the D100, for the D4. And I don't think this is it, at least not right now, anyway. But it is nice to have the D100 in case of things go sideways. The D100 can at least, you know, you have an out. So, if you're down to, 1 HP against a boss or something like that, you can always D100 and hope that you're going to get some sort of HP or something like that from the reroll. We get Spider Bite, which is an excellent tier effect that allows us to crowd control stuff. The D100, by the way, will do the D6, the D4, and the D20 all at the same time. So you're going to reroll not only Isaac, but you're also going to reroll any item pedestals that are present in the room that you use it in. And on top of that, you're also going to reroll anything that's on the floor, because of the D20. So it's a combination of all the re-rolling dice put into one. But it doesn't have the D10 or the D12, anything like that, or the D8. Thank you. Get Blind Rage here. Blind Rage is going to increase the amount of damage, the amount of time that we have, assuming that we take damage, but
we're too good for that. We never take damage in Isaac. No way, bro.
Yeah, right. Here we go. But yeah, today was a very, very long day today. I'm recording this at 11:56 p.m. So it's almost today that I'm talking to you all. It's not quite Friday yet, even though this video comes out on Friday. I'm recording this on Thursday. But had a long day today. Have another long day tomorrow. Obviously, the tournament is it's not going to start today. The editor and I still have some kinks to work out in the overall process. Ooh, Vibrant Ball was pretty nice. Oh yeah, we also started with Belly Button, apparently. By started with Belly Button, I mean we just picked it up. That was me talking and monologuing without even realizing what the boss had dropped. So the Belly Button is going to give us a trinket, and also it's going to produce a second slot that we can hold another trinket in. So it's the reason why we have Blind Rage and the Vibrant Bulb, which is going to increase our damage, basically give us an all stats up for the most part while we have a full charge on our spacebar item. And already, since I've already talked about that I'm not planning on using the D100 unless if I need to, that means that we're almost always going to have a full charge on it. So that's pretty darn neat. But yeah, the editor and I are still, we're still working out some of the editing corrections and whatnot, so it's not quite ready yet. I was hoping to start today for the tournament, but that's just not going to happen. That's just how it is. You know, I'm very particular in terms of what I want from editing and whatnot. And me being a video editor myself, I know kind of the direction that I want to see stuff move in. So we're kind of fine tuning all that stuff, because I want to make sure that at the end of the day, it's presented in a nice professional looking sort of way, and not be janky or anything. Take down pin. We're gonna get ourselves caffeine pill, and we have 3 red chests that have nothing in them. All right, thank you, Stanley. And curse the XL. Alright. Well, our good stats are going to start quickly deteriorating in value. I mean, it's kind of okay, I guess, that we got to curse the... I mean, it's not okay that we got to curse the Labyrinth, but... That's going to extend the value of our current DPS very slightly, because we're getting an additional floor here, but at the level 3 difficulty, if that makes sense. So this is floor 3 and floor 4 all wrapped up into one floor. So instead of it scaling slightly worse for us as if we were on floor 4, we're technically not. We're technically doing both at the same time. Liberty cap is there. We want Liberty cap over... I mean, we may have to D100. I will take the Liberty cap over the Locus of Pestilence, because our base damage isn't really all that great, especially with Vibrant Bulb not being active. I just need to pay attention to the map to see if we're going in the right way. We only have one key, which means that we're not able to open both of the locked item rooms. You see that slowing effect that we get from our white tears is directly from Spider Bite. And Spider Bite, as I said, is real good. It's good for crowd control. It's very good against charging enemies. You don't have to worry about, like, as long as it procs, of course. That's the only downside, is that it has to proc in order for you to get something good out of it. Got a third key. That's excellent, because we have the shop right here and I don't feel like coming back. We get the D12. Burr, burr. Burr, 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 burr. I better stop that. I might get in trouble with the YouTube automatic flagging. I do want PH Dizzle. PhD wouldn't be too bad, although... What if... Now stick with me now. What if we didn't get PhD and we bought the Crooked Penny? Then not only can we take anything out of the store, we can also take Devil Deal items. It's perfect. We've been seeing a lot of crooked panty. Got one of them crooked panties. Been seeing a lot of crooked pennies show up lately, and I'm honestly okay with that, as long as it pays out every now and then. It doesn't have to pay out every single time, although that would be nice. As long as it just, like, gives us one shop that we can duplicate, it's already paid for itself. Almost quite literally, because it's a 15-cent item. Now, in cashless week, I would not be able to do anything. I wouldn't be allowed to use reroll machines, not allowed to go to the store, not allowed to play judgments and whatnot. I mean, I'm allowed to play demon judgments, but not regular judgments, not the beggars. Very odd that there wasn't a third one that spawned over here. Just looking for 1 cent, game. Just looking for 1 cent. I'm planning on taking Crooked Penny. I think it's a good investment. For this challenge, I think that it makes sense. 50-50. You're either going to win or you're not. If you don't win, well, you know, maybe you'll win on the next one. You can't lose what you don't put in the middle, which is true, but you also can't win much either. Remember that. You got to give a little to get a little. We're looking at investment opportunities here. And the Crooked Penny stonks. Is that what the cool kids say now, stonks? No, they don't say that. It's a dead meme. I thought it was an okay meme. Wasn't great, but it was alright. Yeah, see, I told you. I mean, I hate to say I told you so, but I'm just saying. That's all we needed to do. Just get one payout and it's all gravy. And now look at this. Well, we don't want car battery. We definitely do not want car battery. Yeah. That's fine. I will get full charge in here. Oh, well, it's inaccessible. Okay, we found the bosses at least. So the Crooked Penny is going to take a 50-50 shot in doubling everything in the room, or as you just saw at the last reroll, turn everything into one penny. And it kind of makes you sad face whenever that happens. But when it pays out, though, that's when it's like one of the best feelings in Isaac, because you know that you just you it's paid for itself. It literally has paid for itself. And the upside swing to how good Crooked Penny can be is so massive, because you can essentially if this were a non-challenge week, right? If this were just a regular old Isaac run, but you found yourself at low HP and you need to take Devil Deals in order to live, as silly as that sounds, the Crooked Penny gives you that chance. It's not a great chance, but it's not a bad chance either. It's 50-50. It's either going to double everything in the room or it's not. It's that simple. And yes, you don't get a second chance because obviously it deletes everything. And we really need to get damage here. The game also really needs to stop stuttering. Really bad. Unfortunately, that was not worth the cost of admission to walk all the way over here. So we're going to go towards the boss. Well, no, that's not true. Slow your roll there, Buckaroo. We're not done yet. We've got 6 bombs now that we can use to reroll the store. We've got 2 full charges that are currently accessible, not including any that we find in the store itself. Sharp plug is not great for this, I don't think. Mama Mega was just not there. Okay, I wouldn't mind Humbling Bundle. Today's releases, by the way, Isaac is most likely, with the tournament not happening, and me, I've been busy all day today. We're probably only going to have 1 video release. Okay, Crooked Penny, look. I understand that it's 50-50, like, you know, I do, but you're kind of... let's put it this way, the odds have, I think, evened out a little bit. So if you could just, like, you know, hook us up again, bro, I'd appreciate that. I'm going to buy this full charge here. Probably don't need to go for Mama Mega. I think it's better that we wait. Oh, buy that Soul Heart. Trinket Smelter would be great. All right. That, when I said 50-50, I meant for normal people. For Sinvicta 50-50s, well, we all know that that's like a 90-10 right there. I'm going to do this because we could use some more gold. I don't know why I call it gold. We could use more coin. I've been playing too much Epic 7, I think. You can always use gold in that game. Trinket Smelter would have been fantastic had we been able to hold on to it. You know what? Let's go... Well, no. No. Let's keep working the floor here. Okay. I do actually want the compass, and I don't mind paying for it. Which we can do now thanks to the blood bank. So this floor took a little, these floors, I should say, took a little bit longer than I'd like. But again, with them being a Curse of the Labyrinth floor, it's understandable that
Heard you needed 2 cents. Oh, sorry, loser. Why don't you go bomb the beggar, nerd? Oh, sorry. Guess you have to get Pageant Boy, the boss. Loser.
Yep. We really could use some damage here. Magic Mush would be a perfect drop for us.
Sorry, better luck next boss, nerd!
We're still looking for 2 cents right now. If we could just get the compass, you know, that's not stats or anything, but I sure would like to have something positive happen here. No, okay. We're getting the compass. Like, I don't know how, but we're getting the compass. Would have been real nice for the blood bank to have just simply paid out, but you know. Okay, I'm just going to get a chest with no money in it for, like, the third time in a row. That's fine. It's fine. All right. No problemo. I don't know how that caused this damage, but... Okay. See if there's any fires or anything we can put out here. No. Could use the D12 to create fires in here. But I've already used the D12, and we don't have another full charge on the floor, except for the one that I cannot... One that is inaccessible. Get big horn. And, again, the story stays the same here. Really hoping that we get some kind of non-HP stat. Be fantastic. Preferably damage. We've got movement speed in the clear now. 1.85 is a little bit too fast. But considering the fact that the game gave us a Curse of the XL on floor 3 and floor 4, which, by the way, is the worst time to get one, I'd feel really hard done by the game if we didn't get something good here. I think he is... Just HP, and I mean, tears, sure. Get Crown of Light. That's gonna give us damage, but again, we still have the situation of the compass. I want the compass. The only way for us to get the compass now is for me to play the sacrificial altar, the sac room, or if there's some money somehow in the cursed room, which is, I guess, possible. It could be some stone chests in there. I mean, all that blood bank had to do was just pay out. Literally it. 1 cent. All right. Fantastic. We're 1 cent short. I'm about to break everything you say to me. The Crown of Light is going to give us the double damage that you see currently on your screen. And that... Something that I always manage to figure, or to not point out, but to forget, is the fact that you have to be on full HP in order to get any benefit from Crown of Light. That's like four. I think that's four or five 50-50s now that we've lost. So just for the math whizzes out there, just figure that one out. And we'll head on down. All right. All right, so the compass is going to show us where rooms are, but not where they are on the map, of course. the relative direction of a room can be sussed out. And the Crown of Light only lasts as long as Isaac does not take damage. As soon as you take damage, the Crown of Light is gone for that room. So you're highly incentivized to not take damage at all. But especially with the Crown of Light, if you want to enjoy that double damage, then you gotta pay the price. What's the price? Not getting hit. Now at this point, would I re-roll this run? Probably. Now, given the fact that we had an XL floor, and our base stats were good enough at the time, but not anymore. Well, that's not true. I mean, our base stats now are much improved thanks to the Holy Light. Crown of Light, I should say. I mean, we're essentially firing Minecraft diamond blocks at enemies, which deal lots of damage. I mean, 10.37 damage is excellent. And any damage that we get subsequently after this point in the run is going to be good as well. As long as we don't get hit. Blood rights. All right. Well, here's Diplopia. Well, you know what to do, 50-50. Mom's purse would not be great. Ooh, spades doubles our keys. I don't mind rolling through this one. Yeah, humbling bundle would be good. And let's go see what that dice room is, shall we? Yeah. How does he do it? How does he do it? That's what happens when you get hit and the Crown of Light is dispelled. There we go. But luckily, as long as you have full HP, it comes back, thankfully. Yep. Sorry, game. Look, you gave me the option. I was fine with it. I was fine with it starting out, but not anymore. After so many failed 50-50s, I am perfectly happy to yeet the crooked penny out. Now we have the mind. No, we have the treasure map. We have the treasure map, and I guess Liberty Cap had procced at some point, or it's because we also had the compass, maybe like slightly. For a split second, they overlapped or something. There's no discernible reason why. There's no discernible reason why we should have the compass effect right now that I'm seeing. Nun's Habit, Little Steven, Sackhead, the map, Charm of the Vampire, Mr. Dolly, Contagion, I think, or that might be, no, it's Toxic Shock. Now the problem is that our base damage got shot to hell. I mean, we have terrible damage. Our tears rate's good. Where the damage down is stemming from is from Skinny Odd Mushroom. Which tears rate was never the problem on this run. It was just the fact that we didn't get any shop items. Get a sticky nickel here. That's good. We were actually like moving at a. You know what? I don't even want the blood bag game. Let me guess, counterfeit penny? No. Okie dokie, here we go. Now we can just keep on rolling. Yeah, the reroll didn't help us. It made us markedly worse. Substantially worse. I guess I should have been happier with what I had, but here we are. I mean, honestly, like, I wouldn't feel so salty if I didn't just get, like, hosed out of, like, five 50-50 rolls. But it doesn't matter anymore. Because this is the run we've got now. And we gotta live with it. No matter what. You only get one run. It only takes one run to lose a streak. It takes hundreds to make a streak. It takes one to lose one. And will this be the one that loses the streak? I hope not, but right now it's not looking great. Wow. That was a super quick shot by Monster, too. So the angelic prism is the thing that you're seeing right there, which is refracting and bending our tears. Charm of the Vampire giving us some free heals there. been a pretty long-range Monstro. Usually they don't fire. Usually they fire, but it usually takes a little bit more of Isaac hanging around in one position for them to decide to fire. I'm gonna get some good damage there with the prism. Yeah, this one's like, this monster is like quick draw Magal. I don't know who Magal is. Magal? A cat of nine tails, which is a damage up, thankfully. And we get Sacred Heart. Okay. Damage problem taken care of. The Chosen One has arrived here to save us. Blessed thee, O holy, gracious, Sacred Heart. The Sacred Prism. And the thing, the sad thing is that it would be so much stronger if I had kept Crown of Light. So much stronger. And Curse the Blind. Who freaking cares, man? Cat of Nine Tails into Sacred Heart with Angelic Prism. Again, it had we had... This is not a library. Yeah. Clown Fiesta in there. Had we had Crown of Light, it would have been even better, but you're seeing how much damage now that Toxic Shock is doing, and that's the big thing. Talking about having the best, a good defense is a good offense. Is a superb offense. There you go. Sacred Heart is your best defensive item. Whipworm's actually not terrible for Sacred Heart. There's options. Completely useless. Now, it is kind of unfortunate that we lose Small Rock, which is great. We do lose Vibrant Bulb, which is, again, still not that big of a deal. I would rather have Whipworm here just because, as you're seeing here, the potential for damage is just incredible. And Sacred Heart brings a lot to the table in terms of damage. Now, that bomb was homing for some reason, even though we don't have Bobby Bombs, at least not to my knowledge. So it may have inherited the homing properties of Sacred Heart. It's possible. I don't know why I thought anything was there. We found some good luck here. Juice's tongue is completely useless for a run that we're not taking any Devil Deals on. I don't know what hit me there. That was weird. I was watching the prism while waiting for the button to activate. I might have missed it. But yeah, obviously Sacred Heart, massive amounts of damage. One of the rarest items in the game. My second favorite item in the game. We get another Angel Deal here, which is going to allow us to get to Mega Stanley. We get the Bible, which is, I guess, okay. Could have been worse. Could have been like the shield or something. And I tell you what, the Angel Deals are really coming out, and they're making a case for themselves this week. Those Angel Deals really want to be in the discussion of the metagame and whatnot. The Bible is going to give us flight for one room, but the most common use of the Bible is just insta-giving Mom and Mom's Heart. What am I doing? That was the boss room. Okay, yeah, we took so much damage there because I was not looking at the screen. I was stunned to see that the boss room was over here. I'm gonna actually use the Bible here just so we don't have to worry about the spikes. I mean, we're not gonna get a deal. We took too much damage. Get HP or HP? Fantastic. What a weird boss room location. Get ready, everyone. New gacha game coming out. It was supposed to be out, I think, today, actually. Today being the 16th, even though for you it's the 17th. And it hasn't... It's been delayed or something, but it's one that I only recently found out about. And it looks interesting. I don't know if I'm going to like it as much as other as the, my current ones, but hey, I'm always excited to have a new gacha game to play. Called Ark Knights, and it looks interesting. There goes that soul heart, by the way. Pretty good about that. It definitely looks like they're another company is trying to muscle in on Epic 7's corner of going for like a super anime style of art, which works, of course, as long as it's done with good voice actors. Not the terrible ones that some of the Epic 7 voiceovers have. We get the insta-gib on mom there. Gonna skip through everything. But obviously, we're gonna get a win here. It feels good. I was worried after we re-rolled. The re-roll was awful. It was straight up awful. Thankfully, it worked out in our favor eventually. But at what cost, you may be asking? Well, at the cost of, I guess, some worrying. Not sure if that's a tangible cost to something. I've been having fun playing with Huts and Risk of Rain 2 on his stream lately. Going for stuff. Going for achievements and whatnot, and I've been keeping a running tally of every time that I save Huts or every time that like I have to buy an item for Huts, he owes me like so many lunar coins and whatnot. It's been fun hanging out and playing with Huts. And the streams seem to really be enjoying it as well, which is good. But like that's not surprising, you know, like Huts from the second that that Huts and I first talked to each other, I was like, yeah, you just kind of know how a person is, you know? You know what I mean? There's just some people in the world that you know exactly how they're going to respond and how they're going to behave and whatnot. And just how they are without even knowing them, you know? So it's been neat hanging out with Huts and playing games and stuff. This community is really, really cool. I enjoy interacting with them all. But Risk of Rain 2, it's always been fun. That's the thing about Risk, is that it's always been fun. It's never been unfun. It's just not very satisfying to play, if that makes sense. It's not very satisfying to play in the sense that, like, you're on a run for, like, an hour or two, and then you just get one shot. It's sort of like having like 3 or 4 victory laps under your belt as Isaac, turning into loss and then losing to like a small spider. That's what it feels like. Like death always feels terrible in Risk of Rain 2. It's very unsatisfying. My eyes tricked me there. I thought I was further to the right. But instead I was looking straight at the shot that came and hit me. I'm not really trying for Angelic Prism here. And no, it's not Angelic Prison, but Prism. I don't know where that shot was going, Sloth, but that was pretty... That was actually pretty impressive. Take care of all the sides here. Should try to get death as soon as we can. If you find yourself in this position where you are massively ahead in terms of damage... But some of that is dependent on the positioning of Angelic Prism. Obviously, don't prioritize the Prism over getting hit. Never a good idea for that. All the stuff on the ground right now, I'm making shots a little difficult to see. Now, of course, we didn't have to go fight Mega Stanley, but No, it's Sacred Heart. We gotta do something. It's Angel Week, man. We gotta tell Stan, hey, listen, Stan, your deals haven't been up to snuff. The big guy upstairs has been hooking us up pretty fat lately with Godhead and Sacred Heart. I mean, man, Stanley, you're gonna have to impress me. I love how that's the shot that we got hit by was Mega Satan's random wailing. Trying to line up for the prism here. There we go. Get some nice spread damage action, you know. Little Steven holding down the fort, as always. I know that I don't take you very much in any of my runs anymore, but that's just because, you know, it's guilt by association. You're a good player, Little Steven. Don't get me wrong. It's just that the plays that you make aren't the big time plays that I need. Now it goes Mega Satan. We're going to get ourselves a Sacred Heart win. Feels good, man. Feels good. So yeah, there probably won't be a second video today. Again, I spent the majority of the day out doing band stuff and then meeting with the editor. Hopefully the tournament starts this time next week, I'm guessing. I'm hoping. But either way, thank you all very much for the support. Click the like button if you like this run. Hey, it had Sacred Heart in it, and we got Mega Stanley down. I think that's good enough for a like. But if not, click the dislike button or leave a comment down below and tell me why you do or do not like the video. And as always, hope you had a great start to your weekend, and I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.